Life as a Christian can be very difficult. We have battle after battle going on all around us. But are you putting on the full armor of God? Because at least with that, you have a chance. On this edition of After God's Own Heart, I'm going to show you how to do just that. After God's Own Heart, how I long to be what it wants me to be. After God's Own Heart, oh, no other love means so much to me. I will follow after God. Hi everyone, I am Ray Gauthier. Welcome to this edition of After God's Own Heart. The title of this video, The Armor of God. And we are going to be reading from Ephesians chapter 6, verses 10 through 18. And the reason why I'm touching on the armor of God as a topic in this video, and that is because as Christians, as believers, we are constantly at war. And I'm trying to encourage the believers out there and those that have given their life to Christ, those who are considered Christians, to realize that even though you're having a really good day, the enemy never really tells us. The enemy never tells us when he's going to strike, and you just never know when it's going to happen. And I'm trying to encourage people to be prepared at all times and to be ready when a country goes to war with another country. They're always in preparedness. They're always aware. They're always alert. There's always reconnaissance that are checking to see what the other person is doing. There's satellite imagery going on. They're watching every move that they're making. They never just, we have full confidence that nothing's going to happen and walk away from the situation and be caught off guard. We have to make sure that we're not in a position or in a predicament like that where we can be attacked without knowing it's coming. And scripture tells us, especially with this battle that we're fighting right now, we are fighting a spiritual battle all the time. The spiritual battle that we're fighting constantly can be very stressful. And there's even at times where people just say, you know what, I've just had enough. I don't want to deal with this anymore. Or there's a certain sin that's in their life that they're just tired of trying to find strength over all the time, and they're trying to fight it themselves. But scripture tells us to put on the full armor of God, that we may be able to withstand the fiery darts of the enemy. So this video is to encourage you to put on the full armor of God every single day. So anyway, we're going to read out of King James. So if you want to go to Ephesians chapter 6, and we're going to start at verse 10. I'll give you a few seconds to go there. Ephesians, and if you're not sure where that is, Ephesians is just before or just after Galatians, and just after Galatians, just before Philippians. And this is a really, really amazing scripture, and I really recommend that you write this down. If you are dealing with battles, if you are dealing with temptation, if you're dealing with something in your life that's a constant battle, and you're wondering why are you not getting, managing to find victory over this, I really encourage you to write these verses down and pray them every single morning, maybe even in the evening time if you have to. Turn this into a prayer, because it's very, very powerful. And this is inspired word. This is the inspired word of God. And if God would not have put this in here for us if it didn't work. Okay, if it didn't work, it wouldn't be in here. And it's very, very powerful. So if you're ready, let's begin. Ephesians chapter 6. This is the armor of God, starting at verse 10. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. There it is right there. Put on the whole armor of God. And it doesn't say you might be able to, or possibly it says that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. He's saying this works. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. This is a spiritual war that is going on all around us. There may be a day that you're just having a great time and something just hits you. You don't know quite what happened. And you go into this depression, or you're being tempted from all sides. This is a spiritual war that's going on. And if you're a believer in Christ, if you walk with the Lord, this battle does not end. You got to remember something. You got two countries at war. One side's going to try to win. The enemy, Satan, is going to try to throw as many fiery darts as you as possible. He wants to win. Unfortunately, he's going to lose. In his behalf, fortunately, he's going to lose. Unfortunately for him, he's going to lose. But I think his arrogance has got him to the point where he still thinks he can win. So, this clearly tells us that there is a massive spiritual war going on all around us. Just because you don't see it, just because you're having a good day, doesn't mean there's not a major war going on around you, because there is. All right, verse 13. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness. Okay, here we are now, like a soldier. Christian soldier, we are arming up for the big battle. And if you've never done this before, this armor should never come off. It should just be reinforced and tightened up every single day. 15, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. 16, above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one, or of the wicked. I'm paraphrasing again. I got a habit of doing that. So here we are, the shield of faith. Think of that. We have a shield. It's the shield of faith. And what does that mean? I have faith and trust that the Lord is by my side. I have faith that I'm a child of God, that the fiery darts will have no effect on me. Faith is everything. Faith is so important, I'm telling you. You lose your faith, the darts will get through. And if you find yourself losing faith, go back and read this and tighten up the armor of God, or put it back on. Verse 16, above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. And take the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. I like this part. And the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. The sword. Remember when John sees a vision of Yeshua coming back, and he says his eyes are like fire, and his tongue is like a two-edged sword. And if you're wondering what that means, back in the ancient days, the two-edged sword was so deadly. You would have the regular sword, which had the sharp edge on one end. You could stab somebody and only go into one direction to slice in, slice into their flesh. But a two-edged sword, it was an instant kill. In, down, up. Person's dead instantly. The two-edged sword, the meaning behind that, it's effective. It's powerful. And that's why we hear that one verse in Revelation where John says, and his tongue was like a two-edged sword, and he spoke truth. Verse 18, praying always. Now remember this. This is important. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. if you find yourself in just an outrageous battle, I mean, we go through these things. I have gone through so many battles, and there's even times where you just feel like, man, I've made so many mistakes, I'm so tired of this, I'm just gonna back off, and I'm just too ashamed to go to the Lord. That's the least thing, that's the worst thing you can do. Get back on your knees, repent of what you've done, come to the Lord and say, Lord, I'm weak, and I know, I say this to you constantly, Lord, constantly. And then you ask yourself, why? Why am I constantly making the same mistakes over and over? Why am I so weak? One of the reasons why, we need to put on the full armor of God. And that's just the beginning. But this is so important. This is the sword of truth. The two-edged sword, right here, the word of God. I'm having so many issues, I don't know what's going on. How often do you read your Bible every day? Well, no, I really wish I could, but I don't have time. You need to find the time. Here's another analogy for you. One country, another country, they're at war. One country gets together every single morning for a very, very short time to just discuss what they're planning to do regarding this war. The other country, they've got other things they can do. They're not prepared. The other side has a better chance of winning because at least they're preparing. You get up in the morning, you spend 5 minutes. What's 5 minutes? 5 minutes reading a psalm. Yeah, you read a lot of psalms, right? Yeah, I do. I love the psalms. I love Proverbs. Get in there and read the Gospels. 1 John, 2 John. Get in there and read Ephesians, Thessalonians. There's so much you can read. If you're not sure what to read, look online and find a reading program where it gives you, or get one of those little apps for your phone where it actually gives you a Bible reading of the day. You never know what the Lord will show you through that. Sometimes I like to do that too. I'll look on my, if I'm not sure what to read, I'll look on the app on my phone and it's a Bible reading and it gives you a verse of the day. And then it'll give you an option to read the entire chapter or several verses, and then sometimes I do that. So, this is a very brief video, but I really felt it was necessary to make it very, very clear that we are under attack and we are at war, and we need to be equipped. We need to have the full armor of God on all the time. We also need to be praying, because this is the sword of truth. If we want to have any effect, if we want to have any effect whatsoever against the enemy and his principalities, they're attacking us constantly. When a country attacks another country, does that other country just sit there and just say, okay, come on, start killing us off, we're just going to sit here? No, they don't. They fight back. Fight back with this. I'm telling you right now, the enemy, he hates this. The enemy hates the word of God because it's truth, because it's light, because it's inspired, and it's the word of God. Two-edged sword right here when I go through customs. Are you bringing any weapons back? Yes, sir, I'm bringing back a two-edged sword. What? Right here. I think they would probably think I was nuts if I said that. So, put on the full armor of God. Write down this verse, 10 to 18, Ephesians chapter 6. Just write it down. Stick it on the dash of your car, your truck, your refrigerator, your mirror in your living room. Or should I say, you might have a mirror in your living room. A mirror in your bedroom, in your bathroom, wherever you can post it. It doesn't take any more than 30 seconds to read this, but read it as a prayer. So what I'm going to do, before I wrap this up, this video is to encourage those that are under attack, those that are going through real struggles right now, and they can't seem to figure out why. If you're lacking any ability to fight against what's going on in your life, maybe you need to be reading the Word a little bit more. And I'll tell you something, it's difficult. I'll compare this to working out. Everybody wants to be in great shape. Everyone wants muscles, everyone wants to be toned, everyone wants to be attractive, but nobody wants to do the exercises, because the exercises are exhausting. The exercises means you have to commit and do it all the time. But they want the results. Sometimes it's difficult to pick up the Bible and read it because, oh, I could be doing this and I could be doing that. But you know what? Open it up. And if you're not sure what to read, make it easy. Maybe the day before, get yourself a little reading plan and just read something. But I'm telling you, if you want any victory in your life against the attacks of the enemy, if you feel that you're under attack, you need to read your word more. You have to read the word of God more. And you have to put on the full armor of God every single day. So let's wrap this up, and I'm going to pray this with you. This is how I think it would be a great idea, this scripture into a prayer. Are you ready? All right. We're going to pray this to the Lord as a prayer, something that we might want to pray every morning or even when we go to bed. Okay, I'm going to read it and then I'm going to turn it into a prayer. Finally, my brethren, starting at verse 10, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all, to stand. Here we go. Heavenly Father, we stand therefore having loining our girt with truth, and having on, we put on the breastplate of righteousness, and we shod our feet with the preparation of the gospel of peace, and we take the shield of faith, wherewith we will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one, and we take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, and we pray always with prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints. Or you could just go up to verse 17. But you see what I'm talking about. Just turn it into a prayer every morning and just say, Lord, I put on the helmet of salvation. I put on the breastplate of righteousness. I have the Spirit, the sword of truth. Just pray this, that God will protect you and watch over you, and put on the whole armor of God. So I really do hope this is encouraging to somebody out there. Someone who might be dealing with an attack, someone that's going through a very difficult time. I'm telling you, this is so very, very important. Put on the whole armor of God. Read this every single morning. Even when there's times when you don't feel like you're under attack. Be prepared. Be ready at all times. You just never know when the enemy is going to strike. Again, I hope this was helpful. Again, this was Ephesians chapter 6, verses 10 to 18, the whole armor of God. Until next time, God bless you all. In the name of Yeshua. Bye for now.